three issues to summarize today's debate. One, what is consumerism? Because the stance of the opposition was extremely inconsistent. Because the League of Opposition stands up and talks about how they support moderate consumerism like Scandinavia, which was exactly the case given by the affirmative, so you should be sitting over here. But the Deputy League of Opposition noticed their mistake, and they started supporting unfettered capitalism, or unfettered consumerism, such as the United States. We, on the other hand, were very consistent from the beginning. We said that consumerism is a specific ideology, which fetishizes consumption, which creates a norm that in order for people to feel happy, they need to infinitely consume needless and useless things. And the response coming from them was this: do you oppose any economic activity? And obviously that was not the case. Capitalistic economy is a system. Economy is a system. Trade, corporation is a system. These systems can coexist with socialistic values. We told you that it was extremely harmful for these systems to coexist with consumeristic value, and this was the debate that we have set up from the very beginning, and they would completely ignore this point. Moving to the second issue, the harm of consumerism, because we gave you a lot of harm, mainly three harms of consumerism: how it undermines sustainability, how it undermines individual happiness, and how it widens the gap of the society. And the response coming from the negative was twofold. First of all, they talked about how there can be many regulations: cap and trade, corporate taxation, environmental regulations. Now, why would the public, we question that, why would the public have an incentive to pressure the government to implement these kind of regulation, implement these kind of safety measure, when the society is infested and indoctrinated with consumeristic lifestyle, and they want a corporation to produce infinite amount of cheap product, ladies and gentlemen? We told you that in order for that regulation to happen, and we've said that in certain countries that it does, in order for that regulation to happen, we need to gradually abandon consumeristic values, and that was the very case presented by the affirmative. The second response was this: people can enjoy consumption, and if we take this policy, people won't be able to buy cheap refrigerators. Well, first of all, probably even after consumption, demands for a refrigerator will still exist as long as you really need a refrigerator. But second of all, the demand for an iPhone 7, or an iPhone 8, or iPhone 9 would probably decrease, because the demand for these kind of things is self-created. People don't purchase these kind of products because they genuinely want to satisfy some sort of need. The only reason why they purchase these products is to satisfy their consumeristic need. So it's like, it's a tautological circular logic. People want to consume because they want to consume. And the reason why they want to consume is created by the corporation. We told you that that kind of paradigm is extremely dangerous and extremely harmful. Final issue, the benefit of consumerism. So they give us two benefits of consumerism. First, they talk about how consumption allows people to purchase good, and that's how that's good. Then the deputy comes up and talks about this connection argument, how people can connect with people in China, and how that's a benefit. Now, first of all, we accept that even if it is a benefit, like, they haven't really explained why that is important. The importance of connecting with people in China through money? Like, I don't understand why that is important. Moreover, why is it important that all people are able to purchase iPhone 7, all people are able to purchase iPhone 5? They haven't really explained the impact or the importance of these argumentation. But even if we consider this as a benefit, those kind of benefits will still exist in our paradigm at a more smaller extent. We accept that it's going to be smaller, but it's still going to exist. But the crucial distinction that we have to make here is that in our paradigm, we have said that we might not be able to see iPhone 7. So the benefit is going to be small. But at the same time, the harm is also going to be small. The opposition paradigm is this: they're going to have iPhone 7, so the benefit is going to be big, but at the same time, the harm is also going to be big. There's going to be unsustainability, there's going to be exploitation. So we told you that this big harm that exists in the status quo, even if there is a big benefit somehow, is no longer sustainable. The current society should no longer accept these kind of and embrace these kind of values, and that is why the affirmative wins.